there are a lot of really, really weird Japanese music videos out there, and you can spend an entire day just looking through all the really weird and kooky ones out there on YouTube alone. And if you were to ask me which Japanese band I think is responsible for the most bizarre music videos on the internet, my answer would be DJ Ozma. What is DJ Ozma? Well, the simple answer is that they are a three-member J-pop band whose lifespan lasted from 2006 to 2008. The three members are Pancho, the one who's trying his damnedest to make dreadlocks look cool on an Asian person, but seriously, no. King, the member with possibly one of the stupidest haircuts in the existence of mankind. And finally, we have Ozma, who looks like an Asian hipster version of Carrot Top. Yes, clearly these guys had the sex appeal up the yazoo. They released three CDs called I Heart Party People 1, I Heart Party People 2, and I Heart Party People 3, plus 10 different singles. Most of these songs actually have music videos with them, and they're all pretty high on the WTFO meter. But before we go ahead and get started, you're all probably wondering one thing. Why the hell is Hitch doing a top 10 of a J-pop band when he does anime movies? Well, believe it or not, I do have an excuse, I mean reason, for why I'm putting this on AMR. You see, in August of 2007, DJ Ozma released a little song called Lie Lie Lie, which was used at the end credits of a certain movie featuring a certain orange ninja. That's right, DJ Ozma did the ending credits theme for the first Naruto Shippuden movie. So not only is this band associated with an anime, it's associated with an anime movie. So na 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 na. This is one of their most normal music videos. In fact, I actually really like this one, mostly because it's a simple dance number with the three dudes singing and dancing while everyone else around them is having a good time. Yeah, the napkin spinning is a little bit weird, but that's nothing compared to what's coming up in the countdown. There's really one weird moment, and that's when this man makes a Superman leap to light this woman's cigarette. Not to mention, but there's also these moments where you can hear a horse neighing in the background. It's a little odd, but it's a fun music video, which is why it's kicking off our list. This one is also pretty normal in terms of music videos, where everyone is dancing in a steel cage, but there are women involved with this one. I'd say be happy to see women in the music videos for now, but unfortunately there is one weird thing going on with the ladies in this music video. They're getting raped. Seriously, look at this one shot and tell me this doesn't look like rape. There is no distance between Ozma's rampant hip thrust and this woman's crotch. I know sex in music videos isn't anything new, but for some reason these guys get a little too close to comfort, which is why it sits at the number 9 spot. This is the last music video on the list where things start off normal. A bunch of people start dancing in the street wearing their ever so fashionable clothing, with everyone screaming, "Bounce with me, bounce!" And then they start to get weird when this dance move comes up. I have no idea what this is, but it is easily one of the goofiest dance moves I've seen. I don't exactly know what this move is called, but I like to call it the pants on, pants off jiggy. But then the dancers all start stripping King, and then start to take off their own clothing, so that they can dance in their freaking underwear. I'm all for dancing like Tom Cruise in Risky Business every now and then, but dude, you're in the middle of a freaking music video. Get focused. Makes me wonder if this was actually planned, or if this was the group's first time giving magical mushrooms to their dance troupe and just seeing what happens from there. And you're gonna be seeing that a lot from now on. Yeah. warning, this video will get you dizzy since it mostly takes place on a spinning bed and everyone getting freaky. It starts off with the typical hot chicks, and then it goes into the girls in the pink leotards and cat ears. Then it goes to this overweight woman, or at least I really hope this is a woman and not a very large man. Happy thoughts, Hitch, happy thoughts. Not just that, but look at these clothes, they're horrible. King looks like he's just come out of the shower, which helps explain the bubble bath scene. And Ozma looks like a pimp who's about to put some cat girls in their place with his backhand. Plus, I refuse to believe that Pancho chose those clothes himself. I mean, look at him. He looks like an S&M biker that's covered in golden ivory. Nothing about that outfit says any heterosexual male wore that willingly without losing some kind of a bet. Although, let's just say it wouldn't surprise me if he did choose that willingly. Let's move on. Oh. Now, the first question that should be on everybody's mind is a simple one. Why the hell are these guys dressed as the Beatles from Sgt. Pepper's Lonely Hearts Club Band? My answer, I have no freaking idea. Nothing about this song has anything to do with the Fab Four. It makes no sense. I mean, these guys knew the Beatles were a four-member band, right? They knew somebody was missing to play. Wait a minute, why is Ozma playing the drums? He's wearing John Lennon's outfit. Ringo was the drummer, guys. He wore pink. Wait a goddamn minute. Pancho isn't even trying. There wasn't even a green member. You guys completely fail at paying homage to one of the greatest bands in musical history. And quite frankly, you should all be ashamed of yourselves. Oh, but we're not done. No, that would be too easy. Throughout the music video, you've got these five giant man children wearing white short shorts and baseball caps dancing around like a bunch of middle-aged white nerds shaking their groove thing. As if the image of that wasn't enough to frighten you, don't worry, they transform into an army of Freddie Mercury clones, and then possibly even more frightening, an army of giant babies. We're only at the tip of the iceberg of this group's insanity. Machibo! And a bit of a heads up, we're going to be seeing a lot of men in their underwear from this point on. Just fair warning. If you're wondering why Spider-Man wasn't included in the recent Marvel anime lineup, there's one reason for it. Japan is not allowed to touch Spider-Man ever again, and yes, DJ Ozma is to blame for this. Yes, this is their music video for Spider-Man. I mean, if it didn't have this guy in this incredibly awesome Spider-Man 3-piece suit, I would confuse this for gay porn. I have no idea how they got from friendly neighborhood Spider-Man to this. Hey, we gotta go ahead and do that Spider-Man music video. Do you have any ideas what we're gonna do? Let's go ahead and have us all in a giant dancing number like we always do, but let's go ahead and all of us wear Spider-Man masks. Alright, I like that. Yeah, I can see that one. And then we can go ahead and have all the background dancers dancing around their underwear with spiders on them. Oh, that sounds sexy. You go ahead and put everyone together and I'll go ahead and film it. You didn't tell me that all the dancers were going to be men. Did I? I'm sorry, but is it fair to say that there are way too many crotch shots and air humping going on for a music video about Spider-Man? I think so. God, I can't even imagine what was going through Stan Lee's mind when he saw this for the first time. Oh, but don't worry, it ends with all of them going to hell. So there's some justice in the world, I guess. The Spider-Man. Are you ready? No, you're not ready for this. This is straight up nightmare fuel. Pure and simple. Never in one musical sequence has there ever been such a large collection of pedophiles on one stage. Look at these people and tell me that that isn't the smile that wants to touch children in their naughty places. These people look way too happy and creepy to be anything but child molesters. It's actually not that hard to imagine this face looming through a window or hiding in a closet. But then let's not forget about this little bit of creepiness. I have no idea why this is in here outside of adding to the things that you're going to be seeing in your nightmares. And then the granddaddy of all things creepy, a group of naked dancing men wearing the creepiest mask imaginable. While the other guys might be pedos, these guys are serial killers. Who the hell wears leather masks naked while wearing a red ogre mask to cover their Johnson? A serial killer, that's who. Oh, and if this doesn't help explain why DJ Ozuma's logo is a freaking mushroom, then I'm afraid I can't help you on that one. This is one of those music videos where it's not just uncomfortable, it's just straight up frightening. Let's go ahead and review the past music video so that we can get a better perspective of this next one. We have come to the conclusion that 1. They're all on drugs, 2. They rape women, 3. They're a bunch of furries, and finally, they know how to rape childhoods in more way than one. So what's a logical situation put these guys into? Put them in a room full of children! If you have no previous knowledge of the band before seeing this video, you might think it's charming. But dude, these people have all the qualifications of being tracked by Child Protective Services. Who thought this was a good idea? Let's put 3 grown men who are known for flirting with women, being associated with some of the shadiest people on the planet, and have these guys walk into a room full of 3-year-olds wearing drug paraphernalia. This is just a bad, horrible, icky idea. But there is one hilarious thing about this video. The next time you check out this music video, during the group dance sequences, watch for the kid in the yellow shirt. Either this kid just doesn't have a clue to what's going on, or he really just doesn't give a shit. I like to think it's the latter. But yes, this is a little too icky for me, given the band's history, which is why it's at number 30. Alright, I gotta admit, this video starts out really strong. Nice, pretty imagery, and you see King singing next to a candle. And for a brief second, you think this might be very normal. Then the sad, cruel reality kicks you in the balls when you realize that this is a giant dance sequence with nothing but naked men, who are only covering themselves with red fans. Oh, but it would be too simple if they only dance. Let's have them play volleyball, baseball, roller skating, and jump rope. Although, I have to give credit and admit that the choreography is actually pretty good, and you never see a man's jewels in the whole video. Oh, but there are plenty of ass shots. Far more than I care to count, and I think the ass counter is another show. But the asses aren't what you should be afraid of. No, it's the things that come out of their ass. Like, confetti! And ping pong balls. Although this scene does make me giggle immaturely. So, yeah, naked dancing men with fans. Couldn't possibly get any more weird than that. Which brings me to my number one pick for DJ Ozuma's most bizarre music video. And honestly, this one is so direct and forward that I really can't say anything about it. Here are clips. There's no way around it. There's no, oh, this dude's just giving him a friendly leg massage, and he just went for his goods. In the imagery of the dangling disco balls and the shirtless men jumping in joy and ecstasy, it's enough to make the gayest man on earth go, oh, that's a little over the top. And drills? Seriously? But yes, those are my picks for DJ Ozuma's most bizarre music videos. Now if you'll excuse me, I need to go pour bleach into my eyes. This is Hitch, signing out.